Hey, you guys, it's In the Street with Tina B.
And Mr. Ollie, what up, Joe?
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year! We are back, you see.
We need some noisemakers.
Nice and festive.
Really?
You're supposed to sing it. You're supposed to say happy
New Year.
Sexy chocolate. Give it up some chocolate.
Yay. Welcome to 2019, you guys.
Yes, we are back in full effect.
We are back. We are so excited. We made it to another year.
Yes, we did. Yes, we
so
did.
So how was your last night? How was your last night?
You know what? It was very peaceful. Family is in town. Mama and cooked everything in the kitchen. When I say everything, I mean everything.
Mm-hmm.
I'm coming back for some more of them chitlins. But
yeah, wait. Did you say chitlins?
Yeah, mama made chitlins.
You eat chitlins?
Yeah, I eat.
Just when you think chitlins. You know someone.
I eat chitlins. Mm. I do. Mm. It feels a little judgy in here right now. Are you judging me?
Very much so.
So that's what we do in 2019? We judge
really?
People
that's what we're going to do? That's what's going to happen every time something go down in 2019.
At least for the first 2 weeks of the year.
That's what we're doing? That's what we're doing, eating chitlins in 2019?
That's what we do. We breathe it in 2019? That's what we're doing? How was your
Oh, my gosh. I didn't eat chitlins. I can start there. How about that? But, yeah, I didn't do anything. I was in bed. I almost slept through New Year's, actually. I woke up about 9:45 and realized, whoa, I almost missed it. What just happened? And me and my son, we drank our cider. He's 22. We still drink cider.
Okay.
And that's his thing. We always did that when he was younger, so we still do that. And me and him and his girlfriend, we drank some cider, and I went back to bed.
So did he drink? Do he drink?
Yeah, he do drink.
Oh, okay, so he did
I'm sure he
too.
Did the cider, and then he went downstairs and drank what he really wanted to.
Oh, okay.
Yes,
yeah,
he was absolutely.
He was trying to appease mama.
That's right. That's our thing. That's what we do. We drink. We get us a bottle of cider, and we drink ever since he was little. That's what we did. But so
you know
we still keep the tradition going.
You know what I did do, though? On Saturday, I had my first hosting gig outside of poetry. Well, my second, actually, because I hosted the pre-show for the fashion show.
Yeah.
And that was, I had a good experience.
You had a good time with that?
Yeah, I did. Shout out to Jay Legacy for giving me the opportunity. I had fun. It was nice.
Cool.
I enjoyed that.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
That's what's up.
These glasses doing something to my eye.
I
know,
right? I got to
take them off. We going to take them on?
Yeah,
we going to take them on?
Yeah. Okay. We just bringing the year in.
Yeah,
you
I
know
feel
what
like
saying?
A superhero.
Yeah, you look like one. Super Negro. That's what you look
dun,
like.
Dun, dun, dun. You see what I did there?
Yeah. And you got the Black Panther shirt on, too, so you ready to save the world. Save the world.
Ooh. Wakanda forever.
Uh-oh.
You see my accent? You see
what
I did there?
That's what's up. Voiceover?
See, I'm trying to. Hey, I'm trying to for 2019.
Yeah, you got
to
put your hands in everything.
I'm doing voiceover.
But you know what?
Yes.
Speaking of voiceover, I don't know how that flows, but anyway, we have a media mixer on January 13th right here. If you always want to be in radio, TV, it's not just radio around here. ATL's hottest station. This network, I should say, this is where you want to be on January 13th from 4 to 7 p.m. Mm-hmm. Come out right here at Status Network Media Mixer, 777 Cleveland Avenue, Atlanta, Georgia, 30315, Suite 406. Come out, come have some fun, meet us, meet all the other personalities in the building, and be a part of the family. It's an excellent business to be a part of. Status Network is blowing up big time. We getting recognition all over the state. So make sure that you come out on the January 13th to be a part of this.
Shout out to all the people in the back.
Jack that make Trey, all this happen.
That to make everybody up. See, there's a lot of stuff that go on in the background that y'all
mm-hmm.
don't see
right.
To make this thing work. Y'all just see us in front of the camera, but there's people in the back. That really keep this thing going. So appreciate y'all.
And thank you guys for watching and making us, we won the best show of the month. So mm-hmm. thank you guys so much for that because that was because of you guys viewing it,
yes.
sharing it. And we appreciate that. And if you go to YouTube, make mm-hmm. sure that you subscribe to our channel, which is Global Vision TV. Look for In the Street with Tina B and Mr. Outley and subscribe to our channel as well. And let us win this month as well.
Right. We even got our picture all up in the hallway like employee
official.
Of the month.
We official.
We got our picture all up in the hallway. I was like, look
I
at
walked
that right
in.
There.
I was like, excuse me, move out my way. You know, I want nobody there, but I'm just saying, like, it felt good.
Just so you could see the picture?
Yeah. People was all around it and stuff. I was like, move, Kiki. You know.
In that voice, though?
In that voice? Kiki, like, I don't even remember. But, yeah, man, we got some great guests on the house in the house tonight. We got Antoinne Duane Jones, ATL's hottest photographer.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. And we got Marcus Boyd Beats. He is a live DJ. He'll be giving you all the breaks today with his own personal beats.
Yes.
This is his sound.
His sound.
That he just come up with.
Absolutely. No.
That's awesome.
Who having a live DJ
right. On the first, what? That's how they doing it in 2019?
This is how we doing it in 2019. Y'all better recognize. Y'all better share this video in the street between being Mr. Outley.
Come on.
Amen, somebody. Say it one more time.
Come on. But this is how we do it, y'all. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back with more in the street with Tina B.
Mr. Outley, what up, Joe?
Right here on Global Vision TV. All right, all right. It's in the street with Tina B.
And Mr. Ollie, what up, Joe?
And we are back, and we have a special guest. Thank you, first of all, to Marcus Boyd Beats.
For sure.
Knocking the breakdown for us. We appreciate that. And we have ATL's hottest photographer, Antoinne Duane Jones.
Hey, what's going
on? You got a professional name there, man.
Right, he got three first names.
Jones.
So tell everybody who you are, what you do.
Well, what do I do, huh? I'm a man. Trying to be honest, Outley out here. I'm trying to do everything, but I'm known as a photographer. I won ATL's hottest photographer last year, and now that we're going into 2019, I just got some more stuff to prove. So the things that I do that people don't know me for, I'm going to start doing some of that stuff, but it's all creative stuff.
I know you do a lot of things with Sister Circle. I've seen you on there.
Well, and, technically, we work with Empower Magazine, Hustle and Soul Magazine. Okay. So I'm the lead photographer for those magazines. So we got the opportunity to work with Sister Circle. And then obviously I'm a Sigma and Selena Johnson's a Zeta.
Oh.
So we built like sort of a a collaborative effect. So we started working. I started working a little bit more with her, and that's kind of how the whole sister circle thing blew up a little
bit. Got you. And I saw the photo shoot you did of her family. Yeah. That was dope. And she put it like on a card, right?
Yeah, we created greeting cards. So she sent out about, what was it, 50 greeting cards to family.
Oh, friends. Really? So that's cool. So that a lot of people have that. Yeah, oh, that's what's up. That's cool.
How long have you been doing photography?
Photography, so April 5th would be 14 years.
Oh, wow.
14 years.
Mm. So I got it. What I want to know is, what makes a great photographer? Is it the camera? Is it having the eye? Is it the people in the picture? Is it the lighting? What makes a great photographer?
In my opinion, all that. I think that you have to have the eye. That's just number one thing. So you have to be some type of weird mad scientist type genius and you have to be you. So people know me for the particular style I do with my lighting, but they also, I would think that they know me for the experience. I'm goofy, silly, having fun. You know, I always tell people I laugh, giggle, take good pictures, and go home. That's what I do. So people know me for that. They're like, oh, we had a good time, and then the pictures came out all right. So I keep them coming back that way.
Yeah, and lighting is a big part of photography as well.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So what would you tell someone who's looking to get into photography? What's the one piece of advice that you would give them starting off?
The one piece I would say is it's a whole bunch of pieces, but number one thing is you got to be you. Develop your own style. And when people, I want to be like such, no, to be like you. I don't think I have a particular person. You know, I have amazing photographers that I thought were amazing, but I have my own style. So at this point, I wanted people to get to the point where like, man, that's a Jones pick. Without having to put a logo on it, without having to say something, like, man, oh, yeah, I know Jones took that. Yeah. That's where you should strive to be as a photographer or a musician or, you know, DJ like Marcus, but anything you want to be like, oh man, I know that's Marcus beat right there. That's kind of how you need to feel about your style and the way, you know, you approach your business.
Now I know you did pictures with the smoke. Uh-huh. What made you come up with that idea with the smoke? And it scared me because when I had to read the what you call that thing when you just in case happens.
A little warning label?
Yes. When you had me read all that, I was like, you know what? I think I'm good on doing that with that.
Yeah.
The smoke bomb.
You want to be safe, but I think that I don't think anything's new anymore. I mean, just like movies nowadays, it's going to be a remake
absolutely.
You try to put your own spin on it. But I think the best part about me with the smoke for 2018 is everybody was doing them in like 2016, 2017, and I didn't. Same thing with like cosplay, with people dressing up in costumes. I waited like 2 years till everybody got that out of their system. I was like, then I jumped off and like, okay, let me do this. And then it was, oh my God, it's so amazing because everybody wasn't doing it. So I'm always trying to stay ahead of the curve or wait till everything fizzles out and then do what I do best.
Gotcha.
So yeah, the smoke was the thing for this year. And again, man, you gotta be careful. You know, we want your clients to be safe. It technically is a firework. So want to make sure, hey man, don't burn yourself or don't, yo, if it's a little spark that come out, so we want to make sure that our clients wasn't burning the leg off or,
you know. Yeah, I was like, I don't want to picture that bad. I'll wait.
And then they get warm too. So, you know, we had the parents wanted their kids to do it. So, hey, we need to make sure this little waiver is make sure because you want your kid to do it. It does get hot. It is technically a firework, so we need to be safe. So we didn't have any casualties this year. So.
Definitely this year.
See, I don't know about 17, but 18 was cool.
We casualty free. Nobody got burned up.
That scared me a little bit, but it's beautiful pictures.
Yeah,
beautiful pictures when you see it, especially the pink. I love the pink behind the girl when she did that. And the picture that you postalized, the one the girl's like flying. She's flying.
Oh, which one? The one?
She's in a costume. She's in a costume against the wall.
Oh, the Spider Woman.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what kind of changed my whole career, I would say. Again, I waited maybe like 2 years till everybody got kind of tired of doing cosplay, doing people in costumes. And that wasn't even supposed to be part of the shoot.
Oh.
We were doing a fashion shoot. And I tried to do my research, so I scrolled down her page, and our IG was like, yo, bring that Spider-Woman costume. She's like, whatever. So we got through the whole shoot. Me and the videographer packed up, and I was like, yo, let's ride the Spider-Woman. She was like, we already done. I was like, give me 15 minutes. This might be the best shot of the day.
And it was.
And, you know.
I mean, but was she acting like she climbing a wall, though?
She just jumped. We caught it, you know, like three takes. We caught her on the wall, and, man, that picture, between the two that we posted, you know, like One got like 50,000 views or something like that. Yeah. And that was the first. That was like one of the first pictures that ever went viral that I shot. Where it was,
yeah, that picture was dope.
60,000 people, 50,000 people seeing one picture over there, you know, a year or so. That was great.
Yeah, that was really, really cool. So being that you won ATL's Hottest Photographer, how does that, was that your first award? Have you won awards before?
Yeah, I've had some. I really enjoyed that. That was probably the most memorable one here because it was my first one here. So nobody really knew me per se. They knew all my work, but I was still kind of like an outsider because, I mean, I just, like I said, laugh, take good pictures, go home. So I needed to get out more. My PR was like, you need to do more, get out more because you just, you know, people need to know you in Atlanta, and they didn't really know me. They just knew my work. So
yeah, and the thing is, you don't go to a lot of stuff.
Right.
You are very picky choosy about where you go, and that keeps the mystery of who you are, and people want to book you that way.
Yeah, that's single daddy life, though. I mean, I would rather be at home than running the streets, but I do understand it's a necessity to be seen and known a little bit in the ATL area. So
yeah, people want to know that people, you know, support what you do. You know what I mean? So it's like, I found that out, that people want to support you when you support them.
Says the person that's always in the street.
Everywhere, in the streets. I mean, I can't be like, is it Tenetina? Like, she be everywhere.
Is it
she got twins. She got a triplet somewhere high.
Right, right.
Yeah, she what tend to be everywhere, say. So. We work on
that. But I like supporting people, you know what I'm saying? So, and I got some great shots from you. And we did a calendar, and I put one of your pictures in my calendar.
Dope.
So then you got a calendar under your belt. You got a couple of covers for a Bold Ageless, right?
Yeah,
you got the president.
Presidential one, and then
Tanya. Sunflower is on the cover. Yeah. So you got two covers for Bold magazine as well.
Waiting on that call back, you know what I'm saying? Ready to get back on the payroll.
Right, right.
But yeah.
So that's what's up, man. It's just, that's how it's what it's about, though. So what advice you give to someone out there who want to pick up a camera and go for it? Is it just that simple as picking up a camera, or is it a?
Because you can be. It seems like people using their iPhones to be a photographer, and all of a sudden they're a photographer now.
Right, and my note to that, because I'm particular and I'm old. Like, I'm getting older now, so even though I have the baby face, people don't know that I'm 40, so they kind of treat me a different way. Mm. But I would say that when it comes down to photography, like anything else, let somebody else call you whatever it is that you are before you call yourself that. Mm. And that's when we get to the point of you are what you are. I mean, I believe that I was a photographer, but until somebody else recognized you for that, you know, it's like my man said, he the greatest R&B singer of all time.
Exactly.
Hey, man, that's what you believe. You believe that in your heart,
you
but I would rather
it,
somebody
so.
Else.
You say it.
Hey, man, you a dope photographer to me. I'm the dopest, though. Where's your backing on that? How many votes you got as far as, like, who really will support your business? So that's what I would tell people. Just work hard, and then when other people start recognizing the work that you do, because I got a whole bunch of no's, and I'm still getting no's. Man, let's work. Get at you. Later, you know, but now it's starting to come out because all I did was work. You know, I didn't care about titles. Again, I wasn't everywhere. I was just doing work, going home, and then I finally started to get a little recognition, and then just kept working and grinding and grinding.
You recognize now with this, with Sister Circle and Selena Johnson. That's what's up. Now, I know you got a Barbie doll, I think it is.
Yes, fundraiser.
Photo shoot as well. So tell us about that coming up.
So not many people know that my degree's in marketing.
Okay.
So I wanted to kind of use 2019 to kind of step out and start helping people with their brands and doing more because I need to get out. So the first event I will have in the Atlanta area, because this is going on, what, year three for me.
Mm-hmm.
The first event I'm going to have is a charity cancer fundraiser. It's called BACK. So it's a Barbie Dolls Against Cancer.
Okay.
So we're going to have everybody come all dressed up, men, women, children, doesn't matter what age. It's only $50. The money's going to a cancer charity. And we're just going to have everybody jump in a big life-size Barbie box, and you're going to take a picture like a Barbie. So it could be Ken. You could be Ken. You could come as with a wedding dress on. You come as a rock star. You can come as a basketball player. Whatever you want to do, just come. Enjoy the moment. I'm going to be taking all the pictures. We got some vendors that are going to be here, some sponsors. We actually have a cancer conqueror that we're going to take her from start to finish. So she's going to come sit in a chair, close her eyes. We're going to do hair, makeup, wig, wardrobe, everything. And then the next time she opens her eyes, she's going to be fully dressed and ready, and we're going to take a picture.
Nice.
That's nice.
And I love the location that you have.
Oh, yeah, Photoplex.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, that's an amazing studio. That's the kind of studio I set up my headquarters here, because I have my studio in North Carolina as well. But it's just a really nice studio. It's well taken care of. It's big.
Mm-hmm.
It's in Gwinnett, but you know, I stay in Gwinnett. So, but it's just a wonderful studio, and the owner Mike there is taking care of me and just kind of welcomed me in. So it feels like home. And then when clients come there, whether they're celebrities or just everyday people, they feel comfortable. Cool.
So how do people register? How do you pay?
Check out the flyer, go to my page or any of my other, my event pages or fan pages, and just click on the link. It's a bit.ly link. And just register. It's $50, you know.
And that's cheap for him because he charges $3,452.98.
No, I'm not expensive. They don't let Tina tell you that. I mean, like I don't think $150 is expensive for 14 years of experience.
But how many looks for that $150?
You can do as many looks as you want to in an hour.
It's just an hour. Yeah, just okay, it's an hour shoot. Gotcha.
But I just think that, I mean, I've seen people go get a face beat to go to the club and sweat it out for 80 to 100. And I can't even get 150 for a photo shoot that's going to last forever. Forever.
Such a waste.
So
it is a waste.
Yeah, such a waste.
Oh, my gosh.
But that's where I come in.
Learn how to do it.
With the debate. Like, it's $150. $150. Like, then you just spent. Well, you spent $85 on a beat.
That's me saying that.
You spent another $100 on some watered down drinks that you could have had before you even went to the club. But you mad I'm charging $150 for a shoot. That's
you talking to somebody right now. Somebody going to see this video and be like, hey.
Talking to me.
Somebody gonna be tight with you right now.
Like, I'm the one to be saying it.
But it's just just really the education on there. I mean, you get what you pay for.
That's
so
true.
Everybody could be a photographer. I'm not knocking anybody on their style, but you know, or what they do with their experience. You don't have to be 14 years in. You could be 1 year in and be killing it. I mean, I know a whole lot of people that I mentor that are making buku money. But
Now with the shoot for the Barbie, how many shots will you get with that? Because, you know, I'm sure
it's probably gonna be like a 5 or 10 minute where you're just in front of the camera and you're gonna pick your top two.
Okay, cool.
And then all the other, if people buy extras or buy other products, the money's still going to the charity from that too.
Cool.
And the charity is Charge Up Campaign, so check them out too. I mean, great. They take care of not only survivors, but people that are taking care of the survivors.
Okay.
So it's a really, really great nonprofit.
Can you send me the link?
I definitely will.
Okay. Because I want to. I'm a book me in one. Yeah, I'm going to do it.
Come. What you doing, though? That's what I'm most excited about, though, is what are people going to actually
right,
wear?
Different
like,
stuff.
Because I just want to see people coming in crazy stuff, clown costume, doctors, lawyers, whatever they want. I just want to
be there for that. That's going to be cool.
Interesting.
Yeah. You should go with Superman Barbie.
It's like a 6-foot box, so the dudes can fit in it, too.
See?
I had to squat down a little bit because you know, I was like 6'4".
You said Superman?
Superman Barbie. Superman Ken.
Superman Ken.
Yeah.
It's going to be dope. I'm excited about it. That'd and we already cool. have, we've only I had it up for about a week. And I think we have already 10 people have already
signed?
Yeah,
that's so what's up. Look at you.
My goal is 50 to 100.
Because nice. That's
this is like
up.
The first one. So when we're doing it in October, that'll start the annual.
And it's for a great cause.
Very great cause.
And it's for a great
that
cause.
That is so good. So y'all make sure y'all check him out. Give him all your information, Instagram and Facebook.
Yeah, everything is Antoinne Duane Jones. So A-N-T-O-I-N-N-E, Duane, D-U-A-N-E, Jones, anywhere. Instagram, Twitter, Facebook is all the same. Even my website is AntoinneDuaneJones.com.
Well, there you have it, you guys. We're going to take another quick break and hear some more beats from Marcus Beats. But thank you so much
for being on the show.
I am booking mine today.
Let's go.
Send me the link.
Let's get it.
I'm booking mine today.
Bring
so
your friend.
Thank you.
Bring your son. Bring your kid. Your niece, nephew, goddaughter, all them.
Bring everybody out there. All right, you guys. We'll be right back with more Industry with Tina B.
Mr. Outley, what up, Joe?
I am Global Vision TV. Hey, it's InDuStreet with Tina B.
And Mr. Otley, what up, Joe?
And we are back. Indeed, once we are. Again. Happy New Year 2019 in effect.
Yes, Happy New Year. For those of you who are watching this right now, you have made it. Boys and girls, be thankful.
Yes, if you just tuned in, you tuned into the wonderful, wonderful ATL's Hottest Network, Status Network, Global Vision TV, yes. InDuStreet with Tina B.
And Mr. Outley, what up, Joe?
We talk about events and castings and just everything.
It's so...
InDuStreet.
InDuStreet. If it's going on in the streets...
We know about it.
Yes.
Absolutely.
She be in the streets more than I do, but guess what? Guess who's going to be in the streets in 2019?
Me.
I'm going to be in the street. Listen, I have made a life decision, okay?
Did you?
I made a life decision, and I said I was going once a week, I was going to get in the street, and I'm going to take me a nap when I get off work, and then I'm going to go out one time a week somewhere in the street. I'm saying that in front of
company. Not counting the show. Because you're out right now, which is really pushing it, you know. You're out right now.
Not calling the show.
Okay.
Shout out to the people in the back laughing at me. I'm not calling the show.
You know he's pushing it. Like, you ready? He ready to go to sleep right now.
Listen, I get my sleep soon, okay? But I am going to dedicate another day out the week to get out more in 2019.
Okay. We'll see. Mm-hmm. We definitely going to take pictures to make sure that y'all see him out. Don't be, taking a picture. Because
I won't take pictures. I'll be out and just be in the cut. And 18 minutes later, I'm like,
Yeah. I'll look over there and I'll be like, all right. Because I already know what it is. He'll be ready to go.
You know what? This what we doing for 2019?
Here we go.
You not believe in it? But in look, me for 2019?
Okay, I got to give a big, quick shout out to my weekend. Is it a weekend? What's the day?
Today is
okay,
Tuesday.
Yeah, over the weekend.
Okay.
I went to the Queen of Hearts show. It was Samantha Sims and her husband, their Queen of Hearts New Year's Eve party. I went out to that. And then on Sunday, I went to I host Me and Saga Boss, which is my family here as well as Status. We host the Black Unity Couples Love show on Sunday night.
How did that go?
It went good. It was a beautiful thing. It was like 14 couples in there that they honored. And they got up and spoke. And they had performed.
Christina
Tiny was there, yeah. They had performers, singers, comedians, Deadass and Melissa. You ever heard of them? Deadass?
I heard of Deadass.
Yeah, they'd be on Instagram. They're like an Instagram sensation.
Okay.
But it was very nice. Shout out to Dr. Angela Harris, who booked us, and Kathy Smith, who held the back down. So thank you guys so much. I enjoyed it. And Howard Gillespie, who dressed me in my suit that night as well. So shout out to y'all.
That was fun.
You like that?
I did. I saw that. I saw that.
Thank you. Then I had the dress on Sunday, Saturday night. You see the dress?
I saw the dress, too. I think that.
Then you smiled bigger when you saw the dress.
Yeah, I saw the dress. I was like, Tia, looking nice out here in these streets.
Yeah.
I see how you're trying to end 2018. Gonna get it to the people.
Get to them. But, yeah, so that was my weekend. I enjoyed that. That was a lot of fun. So we're going to interview Marcus Boyd, Beats.
Yes.
Talk to him a little bit and see what he got going on and what's next. So, Marcus.
Marcus didn't know who was about to cut to him.
Do we need a microphone for him?
Marcus, like, I don't want to talk.
So if you ever seen any of my movies, I shoot movie shorts. If you ever seen any of my movies, most of all the music in the movies are Marcus beats
and
that I use.
He sent me 10 bangers. He sent me 10.
Oh, yeah, to go with your poetry that we're doing. Yeah.
He sent me 10. And I think we're going to be using a couple of those for a video that we're doing for one of the other pieces.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. So his beats are crazy, laid back, calm, sexy.
Just like I like it, laid back and calm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Marcus. So, Marcus, tell us what's your name and what you got going on.
I am Marcus Boyd Beats. I am a music producer, composer, 18 different genres, 8 instruments, 51,000 copyrighted, trademarked, sample cleared beats.
Nice.
I'm an autism activist because I have autism. And I'm a professional DJ.
Nice.
I'm a booking agent. do a lot of different stuff.
Yeah.
And I just made history.
What you do?
2018, I am the first music producer composer who has autism to hit the National Gospel Billboard charts.
Woo!
Round of applause for that.
What's up, Marcus? Congratulations. You need a bill for that.
He stunned with them 51,000 credits, though. I heard it when he said, I'm like, oh, he's stunned.
That
okay.
is serious.
That's serious.
Up,
right.
Man. You know, and it's a lot of people out there who has is autistic and feel as if they can't do anything extra. You're giving them that push to show that you can. You don't have to not do anything because you autistic.
You know, I've been blessed to have autism for 35 years. It's all my life. I didn't start talking until I was 13 and a half. So all my life, it's just been, I refuse to stop. And, you know, I credit my grandmother, my sisters. They stopped their lives for me. So I can't do nothing but enhance my life for them.
Right.
So was it something in particular that made you speak your the first words at 13, or was it a particular series of events?
Well, I mean, you know, the normal stuff, you know, just the normal stuff was going on. But, you know, my grandmother, it was like a Color Purple scene, like for real.
Okay.
Like she put words on TV. Like she made me watch TBN.
Mm-hmm.
It was free.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, she sacrificed her job, all seriousness. She sacrificed her job and everything so I can learn how to read, write, spell, comprehend. She didn't want me in special ed. She didn't want me to be in behind or have me homeschooled because they couldn't control my behavior or my emotions.
Right.
Okay.
And a lot of people, I found that a lot of people with autistic kids, you have to do that extra with them. Far as loving on them, far as, you know, because their emotions, you know, hugging. I'm sure you found it hard to, like, just hug people or people hugging on you and loving on you. Did you have that part?
I didn't like crowds. I didn't like hugs. I didn't like yellow, pink, purple. I didn't like certain colors. I didn't like certain noises. I didn't like a lot of stuff until I was, like, 23, 24.
Yeah.
You know, and I didn't get off medication until I was 24. I'm 35. So, you know, with faith, God, you know, I have a bachelor's in journalism and mass communication from Ashford University. My sisters helped me get that degree.
Wow.
So, you know, it's just, you know, going out in the everyday world saying that I am somebody. I am normal. I'm not different. I am just like you.
Yeah, right. Absolutely. Beautiful, beautiful story. Beautiful story. Well, I know I enjoy your beats. He always sending them in my inbox. I be like, thank you, Marcus. Can you email it so I can download it? No. But I love your beats. I use them in a lot of my movies, shorts, and just any kind of commercial, anything that I shoot, I use your. I can find a way to put that beat in there. So it's really cool that what you're doing. And there's somebody out here who really needs to know to hear what you're saying, you know, because.
Well, I'm just blessed to be, you know, second time award winner, ATL's hottest. And, you know, when I came here, I was sleeping in the car.
Oh,
six
wow.
months later, I became ATL's hottest.
Nice.
So, you know, I credit that to Skills God, you know, the whole KKMG family, the whole Tina Bridges TLA. Yeah. Listen, Tina been like this for years. She didn't just start being in these streets. Okay,
right.
I've been knowing Tina for almost 6 years.
That's when I started.
She was like this almost 6 years ago. So she's been like this.
Yes.
She didn't just start this.
Yes, you better tell him, Marcus. This is when I started. Me and Marcus met a long time ago, and then he came back later. We working together, and here we are. We're doing this thing, and I appreciate you, man. I really
Listen,
do.
Y'all are role models. I'm trying to be like you. I'm trying to be like the superhero. Because he has really good poetry. I'm a fan.
Thank you, sir.
So I wouldn't give my beats out to somebody I didn't believe in. So
yeah.
I believe in your craft first before the music.
Yeah.
You know what? And it really made me feel some kind of way because at the fashion show, after he heard me speak, he was like, hey, I can hear you over my beats. He said, I got beats, whatever kind of beats you like. And I was like, I was like, well, send them to me. He was like, you know what? I'm about to play some. And he started playing them. I'm like, wait a minute, that's you? Because it sound like some...
You already write, too.
Right.
Yeah.
And what got my attention was the sound is so full. There are no empty pockets.
Yeah.
everything is so full, and yeah. I like that full sound. Mm-hmm. And you know, I think it would complement what I do. So I definitely appreciate the compliment.
That's what's really up, do. Man. You're doing your thing, Marcus. We appreciate you.
Absolutely.
So tell everybody where they can find you, Marcus. They want to book you to DJ because he DJs too, you guys. Just so y'all know. Yeah, he make beats, but he can come out to wherever you need him to yeah. and DJ your event.
Marcus Boy Beats 35 on Instagram. Marcus Boyd Beast 35 on Instagram, Marcus Boyd on Facebook, and if you need beats or advice on music or anything, just call me, 770-549-6101. It's about giving back and teaching the next generation. Right. Each one teach one.
That's what's up. Okay. Well, thank you so much, Marcus, once again. You're going to give us a beat to the next break because we're going to go into our relationship segment called He Said, She Said, and we're going to throw some videos out there, and we're going to talk about them. And I got some questions that was lingering from 2 weeks ago that we got. What? Did you breathe? What just happened?
Can I that's breathe what, in 2019? Can I breathe in 2019? That's what we doing?
What are we doing?
We got to do that. Are we still do? You know, we go. Never mind.
Let me reach one time in 2019.
Man, we don't do the hand, so I'm going to just sit here stoic as ever, let her get all that out, and then when we come back, we going to carry that on from 18.
All right, Charles, if you just tuned in, you tuned in to InDuStreet with Tina B.
And Mr. Owley, what up, Joe?
And we'll be right back with more on Global Vision TV. What's up, you guys? InDuStreet with Tina B.
And Mr. Outley, what up, Joe?
And we are back with more of our show. Are you excited?
I am. Can you see the excitement on my face? Look at me in my face.
Now I do.
See that right there?
This is the best segment of our show.
This is the segment that people always tune in and watch. Now listen, we appreciate everybody watching. But y'all can watch at 6 o'clock too.
Yeah. We want you to watch at 6 o'clock.
I know people who tune in just at 7 o'clock, and I'm so not mad. I'm definitely not mad.
So what we're going to, this is called He Said, She Said. It's a relationship segment. It gets the man point of view, the woman point of view. And it's not about who's right or wrong, but it's about, you know, trying to make it work for the both of us. Right?
Yeah, and start the dialogue and try to get a better understanding
of each other.
Of each other, the man's thoughts, the woman's thoughts.
Yeah.
And just from our unique perspective, because people are out here doing it. They doing this type of stuff.
Yeah.
I don't think they're doing it like we do it.
Yeah.
Yes, I said it.
Yeah, he said it. But we want your opinion as well. So, you know, give some comments and give some hearts and all that good stuff and let us know what you think about it. But we're going to show some videos and we're going to kind of like talk about these videos. So we're ready. Mm. Read the title. You read the title.
Jimmy had.
You sure? I'm very positive.
Oh, shit.
Hey, boo, where you at? Oh, shit. My husband's home. Go in the closet. My husband's coming. Get in the closet.
Is he a big nigga?
Yes, big nigga. Shit. Go, closet, now. Go, go, go.
Hey, babe, where you going?
Waiting on you.
I had an outbreak. What am I hurry messing at?
In the top drawer.
Hold the fuck up! So y'all got herpes? And we were just fucking wrong?
Man, who the fuck is this?
Don't worry about who the fuck I am! Where the
fuck you get that from? Out your ass?
Fuck all that! Put y'all clothes on! We going to patient first as a team! I think I see two bumps on my shit. Come on!
That's on me, baby.
Well, first off,
no.
That's funny, but it ain't funny. Because okay. First of all, where did you get the gum from? Somebody help me with that one. Where did you get the
when
gum from?
When I tell you I saw this video and I said, this is the best video ever.
I don't know if this.
Because you are, first of all, trying to hit it raw, okay? You can't trust everybody. She was like, oh, you don't. He was getting ready to get it. And she's like, no, you don't need it. And he was like, oh, okay, well, shoot. How you just automatically just say okay and go for it?
Well, if we want to go back a minute, first of all, why is you in that man's house? Let's go back even before that. You don't go over no man.
He didn't know it was a man's house. She knew.
She said her husband.
She knew. He didn't know.
He didn't know.
He didn't know. So she said, remember, she said, oh, my husband. Then she pushing him in the closet.
I don't know. He should have went to a neutral site. You know what I'm saying? But if he didn't know, he didn't know. But yes, even if you are a side dude, rule number one, make sure you protect yourself under all circumstances. That's all I'm saying. I'm still trying to figure out where that gun come from, though. Now, maybe my analytical mind is going a little bit deeper, but maybe the gun was in the closet up on the shelf or something. I don't
he
know.
Pulled a gun out of his ass.
Literally.
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 That is too funny. The dude more worried about that than him being in the closet. Like, where you, what? Where you get the gun from?
And first of all, is you go shoot? No, you're not going to.
That is so funny. I mean, that's just, that's really, really.
It was.
That's karma at its best, for real. All right, okay. Moving on. I forgot what this one was about. I see things and I save them. I'm like, you know what?
Listen, there's over 7 billion people in this world. You're replaceable. Stop feeling yourself. Just because they've been putting up with it doesn't mean they're going to keep putting up with it. Just because they ignored their work to be with you doesn't mean they're gonna keep ignoring their worth to stay with you. Understand, you are a choice. So don't think for a moment that they're gonna keep choosing you over their happiness, that they're gonna keep choosing you over their peace. They're putting up with you not because they have to, but because they're choosing to. And if you keep giving them nothing but pain, I promise you, there will come a day when they choose not to. There will come a day when they move on from you. There will come a day when they want nothing to do with you. The one you had wrapped around your finger is now giving you the middle finger. The one you thought would chase you has now replaced you. The one you thought would give you another chance has now ran out of chances to give. Look, I'm gonna be real with you. Once they realize they deserve better, you will lose them forever. Straight up. Listen, there's over 7 billion people in this world. You're replaceable. Stop feeling yourself. Just because they've been putting up with it doesn't mean they're gonna keep putting up with it. That's just good. Because they ignore.
So what you think about that? Is that true?
Yes. And I think what makes it interesting is that I think most people have been through something like this.
Right.
And the thing is, everyone has their own level of tolerance. So some people can go years and be in situations where they not getting what they deserve. And 20 years later, they'd be like, you know what? I'm done with this. Yeah. You know, and on the flip side of that is, there are people who feel like they are not replaceable, which is crazy to me, but maybe the person that they're with allows them to feel that way, but everybody is replaceable.
Yeah. And two, it's like you'll see somebody been together for 20-something years, and then all of a sudden they leave, and you're like, really, after 20-something years? But you don't know how long they've been dealing with whatever they're dealing with before they finally made that decision to leave. You know what I'm saying? And it just happened to grow year after year. It keeps getting more and more. And then the 25th year, you decide, okay, I'm done. But everybody on the outside looking like, why you leave after 25 years together? You might as well stick it out.
I think in situations like those, more often than not, there is a lifestyle that's been established. Things have been invested. Children, money is involved. So I think once they've gotten to the point where, okay, the kids are going now. It's just you and I. We have our own lives, own jobs, separate accounts. People can be living together separately for years.
That's true.
You know, and that happens. So in those situations, I think it's out of convenience more so than anything else.
Yeah.
And they still may love each other, but it's convenient.
Yeah, it's a difference. It's a different love. It's like once you've been with somebody for so long, it becomes that I care for you love, like brother and sister type vibe of love. You know what I mean? It's not so much as throw you against the wall type of love.
Exactly.
Affection. You know, that passion type of love.
It's more so I love you enough to see you happy even if you're not with me.
There you go. Come on, say that. That was good.
Yeah, I was.
That just came out the top of your dome like that?
It just came
off
like
that. That's what you're doing in 2019?
Bars. Bars. You see that?
I try not to. I really try not to. Okay, can we go to the next video before he started doing more bars? Because I felt like another one was coming.
Oh, yeah.
You saw this one?
I did. This one right here.
But this is deep, though.
It is.
It's really deep.
See, we were on it because I had something to say about this one.
Oh, you did?
What are you doing? What are you covering? What are you hiding? You're intelligent. You're beautiful. Take a look in the mirror and be proud of yourself. Stop being insecure. Stop having low self-esteem. No makeup. Natural is beautiful.
I like her hair short. That was pretty. She looked prettier with her hair short. Natural. And why do females feel as if natural is not beautiful? You got to have hair or you got to have makeup or you got to have, you know, extra to feel pretty, to feel beautiful.
I think it's a society thing. I think maybe the way that they were raised, the environment that they were around, their version of what they think beauty is was based off something that they might have seen on TV. And I absolutely love the way he led off with that video, because the very first thing he said was, "You're intelligent." Then he said,
"You're beautiful."
She was beautiful. Mm-hmm. So it just shameless plug, but it reminded me of the piece that I wrote for the play, and that was what I was talking about. Like, your beauty is beyond what you see in the mirror. So if you're natural, just be natural.
Right.
You know. So it's.
I think a lot of times too, you know, it's the way a guy looks at you too. You know what I'm saying? Or something that he looks at. Because a lot of times y'all will say, yeah, be natural, but then you're looking at the girl who's all made up. So you feel as if, well, shoot, let me put on some makeup, let me get some hair in my hair, because that's what he's looking at. But a lot of time it's like a guy's just looking to be looking, but not looking for the deeper part of it. You know what I'm trying to say?
I know exactly what you're saying. So I'll start off by saying, first of all, men are visual, okay? So we're going to look, and even if we look, it doesn't necessarily mean we're going to be attracted to that. You know, so it's nothing wrong with the makeup and the lashes and all of that. It's nothing wrong with that. But I think when a man is telling a woman, "I don't like how you look this way," or "Why don't you look like this?" that's where the issue comes in. So regardless of what she looks like, he should be able to tell her she's beautiful when she's made up, or when she wake up in the morning.
Right.
You know.
Right.
So I think that has a lot to do with it. And unfortunately, mm-hmm. it affects some women's self-esteem, even grown women. You know. So
we are. Yeah, of course. Because I've dated guys where you feel as if you're only beautiful if you're made up. But like you just said, when you should be beautiful when you just wake up, when you look in a mess. It's still a beauty is about the inside. It's not about the outside. It's about how a person's heart is to me, I feel as if.
Of course. Yeah, that's true. But again, anytime you're dealing with men, it's going to be a visual, because in our minds, we still like, okay, we're still going to want to wake up with her. What does she look like? And it really shouldn't make a difference when you get to a certain point. You know,
because if you date or marry for beauty, mm-hmm. and then something, God forbid, something happens, then what?
Exactly.
Do you dump her? You know what I'm saying? Because now she got a scar on her face or disfigured or whatever the case may be. The heart is still the same if you fell in love with the heart.
Of course. Yeah. Because, I mean, the truth is we're not going to look the same now 20 years from now.
Right.
You know, and we don't look the same as we did 20 years ago. And right. Personally, I don't want to look the way I did 20 years ago. You know,
right.
So.
Right. That's true.
So when they
That's
say true. Beauty is only skin deep, I guess it's interpretive.
Cool. Do we have another video?
My damn birthday.
Oh, this is funny. That's the dude. Did you see this? This dead ass, I think.
Yeah, it is. He's stupid.
My damn birthday, man. Shit, I gotta get into something, man. Melissa, brother. I'm finna get ready to dip out. I think Melissa's gonna come out. Might come out and try to stop me. Shit, fuck that shit. Dang it. Where you finna go?
What
the hell you got on?
What you mean what I got on?
I
got on clothes.
Shit, you got more than damn clothes on, Melissa. You got damn whole damn somebody out here.
Somebody
out here?
What you mean somebody out here?
Man, you ain't never looked that good with me.
Terry, I'm finna go out to eat with me and my friend.
Go out? Hell no. We talking about going out to eat. There ain't no damn going out to eat there. That look like going out to sleep.
Terry, I'm going out to eat.
I can't tell you finna go out to eat. Where you get that damn wing from?
Offline, I got for my girl. Feel me?
Fit me my ass. I'ma tell you something, Melissa. I don't like this here now. Where you going to eat at?
I'm going to David Catfish.
David Catfish?
Yeah.
All right, now, goddamn, I know for work there now. Don't goddamn tell
you
nothing. Give me a damn call. You going
all
dressed
up. It look good,
baby. Yeah, you look good. Goddamn, you look too damn good.
I know Finna got me. Hey, she got me looked up, baby. She got me hooked up.
All you want to do is all of a sudden we going out now?
Do me a favor.
Do what kind of favor?
I'm going to get you to bag that truck out that mud. I don't want to get my shoes dirty.
Get your shoes. You been getting them dirty.
These some new shoes I got on, Terry, huh?
Go on
look
now.
Look now, I don't like this here going on now. We ain't never like used to do no shit like this now. We ain't go, you going out hanging out. I'm going to start hanging out too now. I'm telling you now.
Hey, my girl said she going to make me some more of these.
Crazy hell, you will.
I paid $200 for it.
$200? I knew you ain't paid no $200 for that and all these goddamn bills here.
Yes, I did too. I paid $200 for that.
That goddamn light bill, $289.
But Terry, guess what though? I ain't got to worry about buying no more wig though.
See, damn, that shit, you paying $200 for a damn wig. Goddamn, you about crazy hell, ain't
she? She making to fit your head. She making to fit your head.
I got something to fit your damn head.
What?
Keep you on.
I can't see. Oh my goodness. Okay, so I like this video because he was talking about going out.
Mm-hmm.
Shoot, I'm finna go out. I don't care what she say, da da da. But then when she dressed up about to go out, now becomes a problem.
See, that's typical. That's typical man stuff. Typical. That's typical, like keyword typical.
Typical.
Typical. And the killer part is he walking away from the house like this.
Looking back to see if he gonna get in trouble. Like, he talking junk, but then he trying to see what's up, you know. But then she comes out, she, you know, looking good, got her clothes on, get ready to go out herself. Now it becomes, where you going?
First of all, why you looking at me like that?
Because you're a man. I need answers.
Again, as I stated earlier, this is the typical man's thought process. Now I'm going to try to dive into the typical man's brain for a minute. See, his reaction to me is his conscience coming out, because he know when he's trying to get in something for his birthday, what he might be trying to do, and she
now
come
she
out.
She finna do it.
All she going to do is eat.
Right.
But he know what he had in the back of his mind he trying to do because it's his birthday. That's a guilty conscience speaking. That's all that is. I don't know about the whole 200. I don't know what wigs run, so I can't.
Yeah, wigs are about that much. I mean, good wigs about that much. But
so the moral of the story, fellas, if she gonna go out, let her go out. So much fun. So much fun goes on at home when she leaves. All the fun stuff happens when.
Really? I would put a camera in somebody's house. Like, what y'all be doing when we leave? Hold on.
Let me look directly in the camera.
We probably wouldn't even want to mess with y'all if we saw that video. I don't even want to see that video.
If your lady talking about she want to go out, you know what you do? Tell her two things. Be safe. Have fun. See you when you get back. No matter what she wearing, when she come out that room and she dressed up and she looking good, you be like, oh, instead of having an attitude because she got on this little short dress, you know what you say to yourself? She is coming home to me. I actually go get to do something to her when she come back. And she gonna be drinking too? Just let her go ahead and go. Thank me later. You're welcome.
All right, and so, ladies, let me tell y'all this. That was his said.
That's what
here's
I said.
Here's the she said. When he's going out, don't get upset that he's going out. What you do, you lay your dress out. You lay your nice little panty set out. Your nice highest heel you can find. You put all that out, and you whistle around the house. You go take a shower. You put on some great smelling perfume. And trust me. He won't go out.
On the contrary, although, you know what?
Because he's trying to figure out where the hell you going.
First off.
You're whistling too loud.
I like what she said. I like what she said. Mm. And if that was to happen, you go, fellas, and you look at what she got laid out, and you like, okay, I like that. She's smelling good. You be like, okay, I get to take that off when she comes back. But ladies, let me give you one further though. You really don't have to do all that if you don't want him to go out. You just put him in a position to where he don't feel like going out, or do something to him before he goes out. And then when he leave, he's still gonna be thinking about what just happened before he left the house. If you understand where I'm coming from.
That was my next tactic. You just took it from me.
Oh, that should have been plan A. Just, hey.
No, well, we got to throw you off. We got to let you know, just because you going out don't mean I can't go out, too. Oh. Because a lot of times I've heard, trust, I don't been on both sides. The cheater, the cheaty.
Okay.
So when I was the cheater, he would go out and she'll sit at home and complain about him going out. Instead, she should have been getting dressed, too.
Mm-hmm.
Because yes. If you can do it, I can do it too. Punchinella, Punchinella.
Look who's here. Punchinella, Punchinella.
So don't just, why everybody in the studio dancing to it? So don't, what I'm telling you ladies is don't get upset when he say, well, I'm getting ready to go out. Then you say, yeah, me too. He don't want you to go out because you might run into him. So he gonna either not go out or he gonna make sure that you straight before he go out so that you can sit your butt at home. So you get dressed, you lay the clothes out. And a lot of guys too feel as if the woman has a child, she's not gonna go anywhere. But we have girlfriends that can keep our child and we still get dressed and we go out, just so y'all know.
And furthermore, to all the gentlemen, listen. Just, if she gonna go out, just let her go out. Everybody grown. Don't nobody own anybody. You know, just let her do her thing. If you know she's coming home, just let her go. Just be, you know, be ready when she come home, because she might have had a few drinks.
Why are you going to keep saying these drinks? I don't drink. So what I do?
I don't know. You go out, take pictures, and you be feeling sexy or whatever. You know, so I don't know. Just let everybody be great. But if they do plan A, plan A works. Every time. So I heard. I read it in a book once.
You know what? So my thing is this. Like you said, just go out, have a good time. We're all grown. You don't own anybody. And I teach my son that. Because, you know, these teenage kids, they feel as if they own the girl or they own the boy. And I tell him that. I be like, that's her body. She can give it to whoever she want to give it to. You don't own that. So don't go crazy if she decide to give it to somebody else. It just is what it is. You know what I'm saying? You have to tell people that, because if not, people feel as if that's mine. Like, you, I own that. You don't supposed to do anything else. But here's the thing.
What's the thing?
I have a thing.
What's the thing?
I forgot my thing.
You know what? I think a lot of men have that possessive nature in them, and I don't understand this part. It's like once they get it, it now belongs to them. When it,
once you lick it, it's yours?
That, I mean, some men feel like that. Once they, damn, that's how you feeling? Wow, I see where your brain at. All I was saying
that once, almost went by you too. You were ready to just keep talking.
I'm like, wait, hold on now. What I was going to say was, once you guys engage in physical activity for the first time, some men have a tendency to feel like it's theirs. And I'm like, hey, no, that ain't yours. It's your turn, but it ain't yours.
It's your turn. I like that. I never heard that before.
It ain't yours.
It's your turn. Yeah, that's so true. That's so true. But I like the fact, okay, I remember now. I got back when you say go out. Mm-hmm. It's so much funner when you both go out and at the end of the night you meet up and you talk about your night and, you know, and you go to sleep. You know what I'm saying? It's like it makes it more exciting to have different separate lives and then come back at the end of the night and just talk about, you know, who tried to hit on you, what you do, you was dancing, this, whatever. And it makes it more exciting.
It really does. And then the time that the couple spends together, you have even more fun because you can do it separately and apart. Especially if you're with somebody that you genuinely like being around. But it takes a certain level of, you know, security within yourself, you know, to, you know, watch that woman leave out the house in them heels that she just had on in the room the night before. And now she about to go out with them on. You know, you just, did I say that? Oh, I said it.
I caught that.
I read it in a book once. Zane
is
off the
what
chain.
Is this? What is this book?
Because a lot of stuff I be finding out, I be reading. Reading is fundamental. You hear me?
Reading is fun. Fundamental. Oh, okay. Do we have another video?
Don't you better ever laugh like that again.
This is fun.
Take responsibility for the men that we're choosing. But then the men, same way, it's like we can't, we're not here to fix them. They're not here to fix us. You have to fix yourself.
And you know what? Another part of that trauma is, like, for me, when it comes to me and I'm going and I'm dating these guys, they want to mistreat me. But then when they go to other girls of other cultures, you know, they're going above and beyond. And it's like, okay, so let me just go to the hood nigga, because the hood nigga already going to go above and beyond when he comes to a girl like me, because he's going to appreciate what I bring to the table versus a good guy who knows he has all these options. He's going to take me for granted. So I'll just go to the hood nigga who going to, you know what I'm saying, take me on the adventure I deserve.
You said something really good there, though, because the good men out there, they think they're God's gift to women. Mm-hmm. So now they treat everybody bad.
But I don't want to put it out. Like,
what?
Can we play that? Can we bring that beat back, DJ? Please, let's run that back. Because you know what? Did I just hear what I thought I just heard?
Mm-hmm. Take responsibility for the men that we're choosing. But then the men, same way, it's like we can't, we're not here to fix them. They're not here to fix us. You have to fix yourself.
And you know what? Another part of that trauma is, like, for me, when it comes to me and I'm going and I'm dating these guys, they want to mistreat me. But then when they go to other girls of other cultures, you know, they going above and beyond. And it's like, okay. So let me just go to the hood nigga, because the hood nigga already going to go above and beyond when he comes to a girl like me, because he's going to appreciate what I bring to the table versus a good guy who knows he has all these options. He's going to take me for granted. So I'll just go to the hood nigga who going to, you know what I'm saying, take me on the adventure I deserve.
You said something really good there, though, because the good men out there, they think they God's gift to women. Mm-hmm. So now they treating everybody bad.
But I don't want to put it on.
Okay. So what you think?
I'm just
okay. I can let me break it down. What please, I think she's saying.
Please break it down. She said.
She said. I got that. Okay, so she's saying that the guys who got a little something, right? They have more options. Where the hood dude, he don't have that many options. So if a girl like her, who she feel as if she's a good catch, gets with him, then he's gonna treat her like a queen. Where this one with options, he got so many that he treats like a queen. You kind of get lost in the sauce. So she's saying, if I get a hood dude, then he's gonna appreciate my sedateness, so to speak, because he's something he's not used to.
First of all, that woman, she's tied to her own opinion.
Yeah.
I find it quite interesting. And my first thought was, what made her think a hood dude don't have options? It may be a lot of hood chicks in the hood. Duh. There may be options to him.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, so what she also said was, good men treat women of other races. That was the part that, you know, maybe was glossed over. And I don't think it has to be a woman of any other race. It can just be any woman. Period.
Yeah.
And it has nothing to do. Everybody got options. Don't matter if you a good man or a hood dude. So I think from her own experiences, that's what she's dealt with.
Mm-hmm.
But I certainly don't agree. Everybody has options. But to your point, I don't see the quote-unquote good man that she's referring to. If a good man with options is dealing with 12 women, he's not treating all 12 like queens.
No, remember, I asked you that before.
Yeah.
I was like, do you treat everybody you date the same? You said, no, you can't.
No, it's impossible. And if any man says anything different, he's lying. He's lying.
Mm.
You can't. It's not even realistic.
Really?
No. Treat them all. The dude got 12 women, right? And you mean tell me you got to be consistently on a certain level with each and every one? No, you don't have that type of time or stamina for that.
Mm.
You don't. If you got a regular.
So why date several women if you're not treating them the same?
Because all of the women are different. Each of them may have something to offer, something about who they are that attracts that man.
So the man can't find that in one?
I'm sure he could, but if it's 12 women and they all have a certain aspect of their personality that he likes, no, he's not going to fire all 12 in one. He better get this hot four or five personalities, hot four or five traits in this one, and go with her. But you're not going to get all the traits you want in one person. So there's going to be something about them that you could be like, I don't know, but he got X, Y, and Z, so I give him a pass.
Got you.
What's he said?
Who? What she said? You said it. But I mean, okay, so I'm gonna say this on the woman side of different guys that we may deep.
Deep. First different. Licking and deep with like, is this how you feeling in 2019?
I was trying to say date.
Shout out to the people in the back. We needed that that sound. Right, that would have been perfect at that time, but I'm gonna give you a bell.
Trying to say date.
Yeah, why your voice going up?
Oh yeah, that's right. My voice going up. Yeah, that means I'm lying. Yeah. That's right. That's
you
right.
See that right there?
I was trying to say date. I was trying to say date. Okay, if we date different guys, I'm trying to see if our do we treat them the same as the one that you. It's always one that you really like.
Okay.
Right.
Yes.
As a man, is it the same? Like, is it always one that you kind of like?
Yeah, it's one that you know, make
that got your little heartstrings.
Yeah.
And then it's pull your little heartstrings or whatever.
Or whatnot.
Yeah. And then it's one or two that just kind of like maybe something that you into that you're in common with.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, if you like music or something, they know a lot about music or, you know, or food or, you know. I don't know, production or something. I don't know.
I get that.
But you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So you have different, but the one that pulls your heartstring,
mm-hmm.
they know about those things too. So why isn't it the fact that you still have to have different ones?
Why do you? You talking about the women. How come y'all still have to have, because y'all might have a dude that you know, you can go out to eat with. You got a dude that you can go, you know, to this event went because, you know, he can dress up. Mm-hmm. You might have a dude that like rap. That's all you want to listen to. Then you might have like a guy who's a vegan, who know what a vegan spot is.
Whoa. Yeah, you back might find a guy that's a vegan. With the vegan talk here.
Yeah. So I just don't think you can find everything in one person.
So do you think that you shouldn't settle down with one person? Do you think that you should have several people that you
date? I see where we're going. I see what you're doing there. You saw the setup? See, let me look at the camera. She didn't think I caught that, right?
Why are your voice getting high?
Because don't try to reverse that.
Why are you getting the calm down?
No, because you're slick. You think you're slick. This is what we doing in 2019.
Calm down.
Listen, I think people should be able to do whatever it is they want to do. If you're comfortable enough and you don't want to settle down with one person, that is your right. All I would suggest is, you know, let somebody know you ain't trying to settle down. That's
right.
It's just that simple.
Right. Communication.
So, ladies.
Communication is the key.
Ladies.
What?
How many men do you think an average woman, how many men does she date? I'm not talking about sleeping with. Just a single woman living her life. How many men do you think she's regularly dating?
Two.
That's the minimum.
10? What the hell? No way.
Two.
No woman is dating no 10 women. I mean, 10 men. Two. No.
On a regular basis,
I say two, possibly three.
Okay.
Possibly three. That's a real strong pop. That may be like somebody she just met, go out on a date, and don't see him no more. But that two may be steady.
Those are regular. Okay.
Yeah.
I was just asking a question. I was just wondering.
And then it'll be one that she may have sex with, but it'll be very rare to have sex with all of them.
Okay.
Because there's always one that we just really, really like that we just want. You know, we don't want to have sex with everybody.
Okay. Is there another video? I like that answer.
Oh, do we have another video?
I think we have.
I don't know if we have another one. I think that was all of them.
You know what? I like that. Jeannie says.
Oh, yeah, I need to show that commercial as well.
Jeannie says if a man is dealing with 12 women, he isn't a good man unless he is being completely honest with each
and everyone.
Is that possible?
That's a lot, though. 12 is a lot. That gets expensive.
Again, which leads me to my original point. Man ain't, no, you're not doing it. Even if you got money like that, you still, again, you ain't out of time and the stamina.
That's a lot.
Do got the money, that's really why you're able to do that, because of the money, and the women know that.
Right.
But that's just my interpretation of the situation.
So how many women do a man have on a consistent basis?
A single man.
The truth. I need the truth.
A single man. You know what?
That's true.
It does depend on the guy, because you really can't give a accurate number. But what I will say is I do believe every single man has options. I would say at least three options. At least. Even if nothing is going on, he does have at least three options.
Is he having sex with all three options?
No, he doesn't have to.
No, that wasn't the question.
No.
Ooh, you flipped that. No, I didn't really? Flip that's it. What we. Yes, you did. You what? Flipped it like said, a pancake.
No, I said he doesn't have to.
No, that's not what the question was.
You said, is he having sex with all three of them?
Yes.
No.
Okay.
Two of them probably, though. Yeah. If it's three, he probably touches two of them. Even if it ain't regular, even if it ain't constant, it could be far few in between. You know, but again, it just depends on that man. And it could be a lot of space in between. You know, so
yeah.
I see what you did there.
What I do? I you like asked the same question you asked.
No, I got a couple things in my phone.
If you just tuned in, you tuned in the Street with Tina B.
And Mr. Outley, what up, Joe?
We do this every Tuesday from 6 to 8. This is our segment called He Says, She Said at 7 p.m., where we talk in relationship talk, get the man point of view, the woman point of view, which is always the best point of view. And we try to make an understanding of each other. So that we can, when you're single in the dating world, you want to know what a man is thinking. But when you're in a relationship, you never get really the right answer. True answer, right? Don't you feel that way as well?
Yeah, I think you're right because you're worried about how it's going to affect the other person.
Right. So that's why a lot of times you have that guy that you talk to and you be kind of like, what'd you think about this? And he'll, you know, kind of give you an answer to it because he's biased. Like, he's not trying to holler at you. He's just giving you the answer that we want to hear. But if I ask my man or the dude that I'm dealing with that, he's like giving me, you know, the PG because he don't want to mess up on that, you know, that morning thing. I'm just saying. What?
How does it, you know, never mind.
Go ahead.
Listen, but see, that's why you got to get to a point where you feel a man feels comfortable enough to just be honest and tell the truth and not worry about the repercussions.
Well, who does that?
Look, I'm not
nobody
saying.
Nobody does that. I wish a guy would. I want that.
I'm not going to.
I want somebody to just tell the truth.
I'm not going to say
that. If you
want to
hit
that,
tell me you want to hit that.
Really?
Yes.
If a dude came up.
I want that rawness. I want that rawness to be like. You know what? If I want to hit that right
there,
fellas,
y'all hit that right.
I want to holler at her.
Her inbox is open.
I would.
Sorry. So if you get an inbox right now, and my man say, "Look, hey, I see a little chocolate cell phone on the screen. I'm trying to see who that be about. What you gonna say?
What? I look at his profile, see what his profile looking like.
Okay.
What he looking like.
Okay. Okay.
And go from there. You
fellas,
know what
y'all
saying?
Watching this?
If he about business now, I can tell by your profile if you about your business.
What you mean by this business? He just came in your inbox saying he want
to
tap.
Right, but I'm going to go to his profile first before he tap it to see what his.
Wait, so you going
to
let him tap it? But you...
I might add that three. I might add him to the three. Really? Everybody going to pass out? Really? Y'all going to pass out on me in here?
Happy New Year.
Okay. So what I'm saying is, I'll go to his profile, see what he's looking like, see what his business like, because you can tell on his page all the stuff that he got going on and stuff. Not you really can't tell a person who he is, of course not, but you can kind of get a feel of what he got going on. If he got a lot of business stuff, speaking engagements, different stuff going on, and you're like, okay, he got a little business about himself. You know, it ain't about a bunch of babies and kids and, you know, wives and girlfriends. So it's like, I'll go check that out first.
Go on.
And then I may answer back.
Wave. Okay, so for 2019, it's not hey, big head, it's the wave in the inbox.
Yes, absolutely.
Hashtag wave 2019, okay? So that's
absolutely.
What y'all doing.
Yeah, I done got plenty waves.
So that's your
and
answer.
And I go to
this.
The profile first. I always go to the profile first. I don't just wave back because it could be the guy from Africa. So I don't. I always go look at his profile first. The guy from Africa with one friend. That's nobody. That's a fake page. Huh? I want honesty. I have to go to. Oh. I was saying that I like it. That's what he was saying. I was talking about I like some. I want a guy that can just be completely honest. He said all these dudes are going to start jumping in my inbox. That's what I'm saying. That's where that came from.
Yeah, and if they jump in your inbox and say, hey, you know, I like how you're looking. I want to see what that be about. What's popping, shouty?
They from Atlanta? Are they from Atlanta?
Yeah, they from Atlanta. So then you go to their profile page. You like what they looking like.
Yeah.
And then I'll go wave back. So what does the wave mean, though?
It's just a hey, big head without saying hey, big head. It's just like I see you. It's a I see you.
Gentlemen, I hope y'all watching, okay? Matter of fact, if y'all want to, y'all can call in and say hi to Tina B, 470-251-4707. No. Call in and say hi to Tina B.
What I'm saying is just a, it's just, that's how, if a guy see my profile, then he'll be like, oh, let me go wave. It's not like he don't want to say hey, he don't want to say nothing out there, throw nothing out there in case you're married or something, because they don't know who.
So basically,
you
can go to somebody's profile page and see what they got going on.
Oh,
You have a general idea. So if Kiki went to my profile page, and she would be able to tell what I got going on. Just,
yeah.
She could tell something.
Yeah, because you're going to have your poetry stuff up there. You shouldn't be like, okay.
But I got a
spoken
word page, though.
Well, but I'm saying, but on your page that she, whatever you wave at her from, she's going to go to that page, and she'll see you did this show. You got flyers up. You doing the show. So she's like, oh, okay, your poet, he's doing this thing, da-da-da-da-da. So then you get an idea of what you got going on. You may have some model pictures up there. So now she got an idea of what's going on. And then she'll go back, and she'll wave back, or she'll say hello. And then y'all start talking. That done happened to me. And then the dude was like, I went to his page and I seen him with a girl. And I'm thinking, are you in a relationship? And he was like, you know, I'm going to be straight up with you, which I like. Thank you for being straight up with me. He was like, I'm going to be straight up with you. Yeah, I'm in a relationship, but I'm not married. And I said, well, you're in a relationship. I'm good with that. I can't fool with that. So.
I don't get women in my inbox waving at me. That's what they be doing to you.
Because they be like,
no, you know what? We're not even. You know what?
They be all in your inbox like that. No. That's why, hell, they ain't got to wave. They no, straight up, too. Okay,
you know, really,
okay. Waving underwear.
So y'all don't see what's going on over here in the peanut gallery right here with this woman right here. Y'all don't see the lies.
Oh,
well, back to being honest, okay?
PSA.
This is not about me.
They on your PSA.
See, this is what
we're doing. They be waving on your PSA. So you didn't, they don't even have to go in your inbox. They be on the outbox. See all them smiley faces? That's them right there. They be on your outbox, not even your inbox. Because you be like talking about soda, and they be like, well, pour it on me. You be like, what the hell? We talking about soda.
Firstly, it's called pop, okay? Second of all, I'm not talking about pop. This is not about me, okay?
It is about you, because we was talking about being honest.
I am. Really? You brought that all the way back.
You're the type of guy that I was talking about. You got to be honest. Be straight up with people. And you always try to act, no.
I do.
You always try to act like nobody's in my inbox. Ladies.
I can be honest in saying there are no thirsty stuff in my inbox. That's the word?
No, but they ain't gotta be thirsty to be in your inbox. They just can like what they like. See, and
just
be in your inbox.
And just say hello.
So you, yeah.
That's it. So, I mean, of course, that would happen.
It's people saying hello to you.
That's it. Saying hello. That's all. They
no, they actually say, oh, I get the waves.
They
get
just,
that big ass hand.
They just saying hello. That's all. They just saying hello, or they might have, you know, saw one of the poetry videos, like, hey, good job. Something like that. That's all. Nice PSA.
And what you say once they say hello?
I say hello back, and I say thank you for the compliment.
Oh, so you didn't tell them the compliment. Yeah, now they just say, wait, is it hello? Or no, is it a compliment? More stuff.
It do be. They may give a compliment and not say thank you.
Right. Oh, now y'all got a conversation going on.
Really? You know what? We are not about to start our 2019 with this foolery. We're not doing this. This is not about
me. You see, he was going to stop at the hello, but then it's all this escrow.
You know what? I'm not doing it. I can't.
Do you like a woman that honest, that'll tell you, this guy trying to holler at me and I may go out with him tomorrow night?
If she wants to. If she wants to.
I mean, you cool with that being honest?
With her telling me?
Yeah. Okay.
I'm okay. Listen, I wasn't always like this, but I'm fine with that. I'm fine with that. I had a woman tell me she didn't want to ask me no questions because she knew I was going to tell the truth. She didn't want to hear the answer. Now, you know I can work on the way I say stuff sometimes. I know I can have my tact could be a little off, but I don't mind a woman saying, hey, I'm going to go out with this guy, even though I went out with you a week ago. She don't even have to tell me that.
Right. I was going to say, she really don't have to tell you that. Right. That's true, too.
Yeah. What difference did that make?
None. Absolutely none.
I had a question for the ladies. Yeah. And this is just something that I saw. And I just wanted to ask y'all. Ladies. Is it true every woman has looked at a man while he's asleep and say to herself, I should knock the shit out this motherfucker right now? Excuse my language, but I had to say the cuss words to emphasize the meme. Have y'all done that?
Yes. When I was married. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I got another question for the ladies. Ladies, what's worse? All right, I don't know what you're going to say, but I'm going to ask a question anyway. What's worse, cheating with multiple people or cheating with just the same person?
Same person. Feelings involved. Knock down as many as you want, bring your butt home. You stay with that one, it's like you getting caught up. Yeah. I'd rather for a dude to go out there, knock her down, send her butt home, and you come home, we eat dinner. Than you being with this one that just you keep.
Come on.
I'm just being real. Like, see, I'm dead ass.
See, we appreciate your honesty that you just gave. See how you was being honest?
Yeah.
That's a good example of being
serious.
Honest.
Serious.
Like, so he can go knock down five, come home and eat dinner. The non-meat food that you got.
Really?
Because he might have ate meat with her, then come home.
Absolutely. Now, if I taste meat on his mouth, then we got issues. No, I'm just kidding. But, nah, but that, I mean, that's being real. Like, wait, that could go so many ways. Hold on.
I was just going to go on past it.
Marcus looking at me. Wait, I'm so sorry. Wait, that went so many.
Pineapple.
Wait.
Too much.
Yes, the whole fruit salad. Wait, scratch that from the record. But yeah, I mean, yeah, it's feelings involved at that point. If he keeps going back, repeat motion, yeah. That's like a repeat offender if you're getting in trouble. You know what I mean? It's like, no.
Ladies, I have a question. How does a man win a woman back that he has lied to and cheated on? How does he get her back?
Yeah, he can't. Let me tell you why. Oh, he can, but she don't believe nothing else he says. Trust. He can get back with her, but she don't believe. A liar is the worst, okay? Because you never know what you talking about. Every time you open your mouth, I feel you lying to me. Once you lie. Because what I don't like is a person coming into a situation calling someone a lie before they even lie. Like, you don't even know a person is a liar. Let them at least lie to you. Before you automatically, you know, brand them as no good or whatever. But anyway, coming into a situation, I trust you 100%. You have to slowly start knocking the wall down by inconsistency, lying, and different things. Like, then it starts breaking that wall down to say, okay, every time your mouth open now, I'm like, And then a cheater on top of the lying, that's like
liar, cheater.
You lie.
Say the song.
Cheat. Yes, I'm just. Okay, so yeah, so them two.
Sorry about that. I had them on. Whatever.
Them two together, it's the worst. Like, how can I trust you? I cannot trust you. I would never. Even if she take you back.
Okay.
It's always that piece behind that she always. Every time you go out, she's thinking you're lying. You're cheating. That's the worst feeling in the world to think that about somebody.
So you saying if you mess up, just let it go. Don't try to fight. Don't say nothing. Don't explain
yourself.
I would say the first time,
yeah. But if it's keep going on and on, yeah, nah, she don't care anymore. So what she's about just going through the motions.
So what about the flip side of that coin? If a woman has cheated and lied, what does she? You feel a woman should do to be able to get her man back?
She can't. I'm telling you, you lie and cheat. That's like the worst thing ever. I can't believe anything you say. I wouldn't even believe you sitting here right now.
So even if... So...
You're not here.
So...
Stop lying to me!
So a woman can't win her man back after she didn't lie and cheat it? She can?
No. She can. But he's still going to be out there. He'll be with her. He's just a shell.
a shell.
I'm just saying.
So the celebrities, you think their relationships?
Oh, please. We're not even talking about them. They're shells. They're just going through the motions. The money motions. Oh. Money change. Money make everything works.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Of course. But if even if he takes her back, he still feel like she's lying. I heard a guy to say, I don't know, I can't trust her. But he's with her. Why you with her? Because that's what he knows. It's used to it. That's the relationship that he knows, but he don't trust her.
He's comfortable.
It's a comfortable situation. It's better than going out looking for somebody new. He knows she's going to come home. He knows that she's going to wash the dishes, cook the whatever. But at the end of the day, she's still a cheater, and he don't trust her. And he's going to always have that in the back of his head. And the minute he's ready, he's gone. Once he get tired of it, he's gone. And here she is thinking, ooh, he took me back. We're building. No, you're not building. He's going to go.
It's Tuesday. You preaching.
I done been through it. I done told you now.
Don't talk about it, Tina B. Let us know.
I ain't got this logo on my chest. Oh, okay. I don't know. What
that is. I was about to say, where did the logo come from?
I'm back.
So y'all the Lion Agency? Y'all lied to me? The Lion Agency?
Whoa, I like what you did there. Yeah, that was pretty good.
That was witty.
Whoa.
Bars. So I saw this post that a guy did, and I was trying to paraphrase it, but I want to read it just to see what you think. And the dude said he saw several posts. He's seen several posts about frustrated women about having guys in their inbox. So he was like, ladies, can anyone write a post on your timeline? If a man flirted on your timeline for all of your friends to see, would you be okay with that? If he was respectful in his approach in your inbox, what is the complaint? Should a man just wait around and just hope to see you in public and ask you out? Have you ever heard a guy say, I really like you for years, and you asked him why you never said anything?
Yeah.
I
had a guy ask me out on Facebook. I'm like, what the hell? Why you didn't go in my inbox? Why are you asking me out on Facebook?
So that's an issue.
It's not an issue, but it's like, why are you asking me out on Facebook? Like, phone call. People don't call anybody anymore. Nothing is personal anymore. No, please, no.
So how could he call you if he had your number?
Well, I'm just saying in general, like, it's just not I don't know. I just felt like he could have went in my inbox and asked me that. Because now I got to tell you no on Facebook.
Oh, so he put it on your page.
Yeah, it's like I'm on a live feed, and he asked me on the live feed.
Oh, he would shoot his shot for real. Hey, you know what? I ain't mad at his approach. Just shoot your shot. It will shoot your shot 18. You gonna make your shot 19.
No, he's not gonna make a shot.
No. I have something else.
Okay.
7:53. Yeah. When it comes to dating, do you have a kid limit? Like, would you not date somebody because they had a certain number of kids?
Oh,
if you're just dating.
No.
That has no bearing at all.
Okay. Ain't my kids.
Even if if he got like six kids and six baby mamas, it don't matter.
As long as he got enough to take me to get something to eat, some pizza. It's not my responsibility.
Okay, so another question.
That's his responsibility.
How do you introduce your significant other when you're over 40? Because the title boyfriend, girlfriend.
Oh, we talked about that.
Did we?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know. Okay.
I was like, do you really have to once you're over 40? Like, we are our parents. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I'm at the store with my mom, and if
the question is,
how do you introduce
them? Is they your girlfriend or your boyfriend? I mean, how do you introduce them? Or you just get them
a friend of mine.
Okay.
A companion.
Or just give them their name.
I'll be like, oh, this is, you know, my friend right here, or a companion of mine right here.
Or just say their name.
Oh, the thing I'm hitting, right? Okay.
I don't know what's really going on today, but this last hour, I think.
But But I mean, yeah, you can just say my friend. It's my friend. Talking about if your mom or something, introduce to your mom or something, or family.
Just family or friends, or you bring somebody. Like, you go on to meet a group of friends, you bring somebody with you, and they be like, you be like,
hey. Oh, yeah, that's a friend of mine. Yeah. That's a friend of mine.
Okay, I dig that.
If you be like, this is Tina, they're going to say,
who is Tina to you?
They're gonna ask you anyway. You're like, oh, she a girl. You know, she cool. She my friend of mine. Oh, okay. It's gonna come out anyway. That it's still gonna be a friend of mine.
So you can't be like, you know, just the one. Never mind.
Yeah. That too.
I don't even know if this is a legitimate question. When I started,
it's the last question of the night, right? Yeah.
I don't even think this is really about nothing, but I don't even want to ask that one because I don't like that one. What does it mean when a woman says she needs a man that can handle her? What does that mean?
It can mean sexually or it can mean mentally. Like, if she has a real busy life, mm-hmm. then he got to be able to keep up and, you know, be where she got this and that, events going on. You know, sometimes, you know, a lot of people say, I'm too busy. Oh, you be too busy. When I'm not too busy. You know, I make time for what I want to make time for, or who I want to make time for. But it's a lot of times people look at it like, I can't keep up with her because she be here, she be there. I can't keep up. So it could be that, or it could be sexual. Like, you can't keep up with me because I like to have sex 3-4 times a day. So it could be either way. I'm not saying I like to have sex 3-4 times a day.
Somebody must be.
Hell no. Nah. I'm just saying in general.
They ain't got no job when they got 3-4
times a day. I'm just saying in general. Ah, not me. I can't do that. What do you think it means?
Somewhat to that effect, but I've heard women say they, when a man can handle her, I guess because she could, you know, talk back and she can be a little feisty. I think women had that thing in them where they could be feisty until they dealing with the man. You'd be like, okay, you know what? Maybe not with him. Because he doesn't carry himself in that way that he go buy that. He ain't playing that. Gotcha. Not saying he gonna do something to you.
But you know what? You know who to deal with and who guys that you deal with. And some guys can bring out different things in you.
Mm.
Some guys you can be like, you know what? And then some guys you just be like, okay. You passive, and some are you're very aggressive with. So it do bring out the difference.
So I was right then. Okay.
Oh, was it a matter of you being right or wrong?
No,
I'll take it back. You know what I mean? You're right.
No, that's just something that I have been saying for years. I'm like, I think women know based on the type of man that she's dealing with how she can come off at him.
Oh, yeah. You
know, I've seen women go off on dudes and I'd be like, yo, like, she really talking to him like that? Not saying I ain't never got talked to crazy before, but I can count. But I'm like, and he's just sitting there. I'm like, wow.
Well, a lot of times, man, you know, don't want to go off on her, though. He's showing her respect. If she's going off on him, he's just kind of passive and showing respect. I'd rather that than him calling her a name.
So do you think that's a lack of respect on her part?
Absolutely. Talk to him? Okay. Absolutely. Okay. No one should talk to you. You wouldn't want nobody to talk to you like that. My mom always said, treat a person like you want to be treated. Don't hit nobody if you don't want to get hit back. And I don't play that. I don't touch nobody because I don't want you to touch me. So, unless you want to touch me. Okay, so that is.
Yeah, she said.
Hey!
You see what she. Listen, I don't know what Tina was on today. Fellas, if y'all need some info, don't ask me. Just
get in my inbox. Y'all can find me at TLAMGMT on Instagram and TLAMGMT.com.
You can find me at Words Spoken by Mr. Outley, Outley. And on Instagram, Mr. Outley 75. Shout out to all of our guests that came through. We have Marcus Boyce Beats.
Yes, and Antoinne Duane Jones, the ATL Silas photographer.
Yes.
Yes, thank you guys so much. Thank you, Marcus, so much. Live DJ up in here. We appreciate y'all. Make sure y'all check us out every Tuesday from 6 to 8. Mm-hmm. And next week, we got Gemini Shizzy coming back.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. And so, if you can, please go to YouTube, Global Vision TV, subscribe to the channel, share the video, get in contact with us in the streets, Tina B and Mr. Outley on our Facebook page.
Yep. And if you want to advertise, if you see the flyers going behind us, you can advertise with us as well.
Interested in being a guest, just reach out to us.
Yes. absolutely. Okay. Well, thank you guys for being our first show of the new year, 2019, in full effect.
Yeah.
It's InDuStreet with Tina B.
Mr. Outley, what up, Joe?
Y'all have a great night.